Start off with a quote by Einstein, which goes something like, "Adversity introduces a man to himself, introduces a person to themselves." Does it mean? So I've been thinking a little bit about that today. And I think that maybe it means that we don't level up as people, mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally. Through difficult times that push us out of our comfort zones, we grow through hardship. I think that's what it means. We grow through hardship. So, adversity introduces a man to himself. Adversity introduces a person to themselves. To me, means that when you're out of your comfort zone and you're put in a difficult circumstance, you continue to level up, or you're given the opportunity to level up. So, growth comes through hardship, through challenges, through obstacles, and through growth comes enlightenment. But then the more enlightened or the more aware you become, doesn't the propensity for suffering increase? If so, I guess your shoulders need to be broader. There's a lot of positives that come with growth, that comes with enlightenment. Like, everything else seems easy afterwards, after you've gone through a difficult time, because you've done it, you're already thinking about moving on to the next part of your life. Perspective, I guess. Last adverse experience you had, and how did you overcome it? I'd be kind of curious to know a little bit about that. think that's a fair guesstimation. Like, being fearful. I mean, we're in a different place to where we were initially, weren't we? I mean, gosh, I was on the verge of phoning Samaritans so many times because I couldn't get through to the NHS at the time. I was freaking out massively because I had a cold, and the whole track and trace system hadn't even been introduced. It was like the weekend where the bomb dropped in terms of anxiety hitting the streets. I'm sure you can recount similar circumstances yourself, right? So yeah, I'm glad we're in a better place now, since, because goodness me, it was sketchy times. Sketchy times. Hey, I might put the soft light off and put some candles on as well, just to kind of relax the mood a little bit. Often I fall asleep using one of these eye masks. Just with the light in the morning when it creeps in. I'm not much of a tippity-tap type of guy, really. There's far superior people at tapping people out there. Systematic way, really. Like I said in the previous video, I had to work all the way through, and still am, you know, providing support. So you kind of have to take steps and measures to keep yourself as safe as possible. And, you know, I know it's a hotly debated topic of masks and protection, but even on a psychological level, I still do now wear face masks and gloves and stay fully stocked with hand sanitizer and stuff like that, just because it's so important to me having vulnerable loved ones that I support outside of work. And, you know, I want to provide support fast absorbing hand cream by Neutrogena. Moisturizes hands immediately. Non-greasy. And that's another thing as well. Like, after months and months of bring hand sanitizer, 70% softbox. Okay, that's a bit better, isn't it? Some days are tough for you. I know some days feel a little bit somewhere in between that place of hopelessness and just needing a moment to breathe. It's no empty gesture, you know. Just below this video is a community of good people, and we all look after each other, you know. We all look after each other. That's kind of cool, I think. That's kind. This is all just one giant soul school for us to grow in, then adversity certainly does that. There is growth in adversity. Okay, so I think going to attempt to go by the store tomorrow and film some stuff. Points of interest, nothing too fancy or shocking. I'm probably just going to go out and film some mundane shopping in the hopes that it will provide the usual distraction and relaxation for you, you know. H2O. Yeah, I think I'm going to experiment a little bit with the audio as well. Maybe peel back a little bit of the treble. I don't know. See if I can do something with it. Growth comes through adversity. Times and there's growth to be found in it, I guess. Spiritual, emotional, mental, and physical growth. Food for thought, huh? Food for thought. We've come a long way, you know. Heck of a long way. Have changed so dramatically in the past 10 years alone. Kind of excited to see what happens in another 30 years. For example, if things changing dramatically in 10 years is anything to go by, of course. I feel like I'm growing so much as a person myself. I feel like I've learned how to better communicate with people, better understand people. Not necessarily have to run to extremities all the time. Well, on occasion, when the occasion calls for it. To spoil the triggers, really. There's loads. There's like a mesh covering on one of the speakers in the background. I kind of want to pull it over, but I don't want to pull it out of its place. I promise you, everything's gonna be okay. Close my work pack. We're gonna be okay. Fiction or Reservoir Dogs. I think it's Reservoir Dogs. Can't remember. Yeah. I promise we'll be okay. Because there's a lot of growing that we're doing right now. And I know it's gonna take time. It always does. But that's all we've got is time. It's not the most valuable commodity, time. It's energy. Your energy. Because we're punished with time. You know, like how you do something bad and rest, my friend. We've got a big day of shopping and thrifting to go through. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite. And if they do,